Southern California sun is starting to set as we welcome you to Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. Ought to be a good one here between the New York Yankees and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Alongside Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa and Danny, as pitching matchups go, it doesn't get much better than what we've got here for this one.
Well, Matt, these are two of the best in the business. Two guys that throw a lot of strikes, and if their game is on, we should have a very low-scoring ball game with these two elite starting pitchers.
It's Interleague Baseball on the show. Clayton Kershaw, a Texas-born left-hander, gets the starting nod. What's your take on him, Dan?
Well, I'll tell you, starting pitchers go, he's one of the best around. He's really found what works for him, and he's had a lot of success because of it. I think he expects to go out there and dominate every game he starts, and he usually does. No one should be surprised if he turns in a really solid start here.
So now into the box is DJ LeMahieu. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man. All even now, 2-2. Game time temperature tonight, a comfortable 66 degrees at first pitch. The 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now a ball lined toward the alley in left center, but this will be pulled in out there in left center. Well hit, but a rough out number one.
Batting second, the right fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
So one out and nobody aboard, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. Throw on to first to take care of him, and Kershaw's in control now, two away. Now to the plate, here is Aaron Hicks. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Just underway here in Southern California. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. And now the Dodgers get a crack at it. No score. Gerrit Cole will be the starter in this one for the Yankees. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Not many better in the game than this guy right here, Matt. Gerrit Cole, he brings the goods. Fastball approaches near 100 miles an hour, hard assortment of breaking pitches, and on top of that, he's a winner and he loves to be a big game pitcher. You'll know early if he's attacking the strike zone and has a 1-2-3 inning. Pretty good chance he's not giving up very many runs in this one.
So here is Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Two and one now to Mookie. Set to deliver on 2-1. Fouled off. Here now the 2-2. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
Boy, not what you want coming out of the gate as a pitcher, right? You don't want to have to show all of your pitches this early on in the game, but that's a quality at bat. And what does it make you do as a pitcher? You have to use a lot of your pitches, and the more pitches a hitter sees, the better chance they have to make good contact.
And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
So now to the plate, Corey Seager. A 1-1 takes a pitch for strike number two. Here comes the 1-2. The fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
Betts is on the move. Pitch outside. The throw. Oh, and the throw's wide as it gets by him at second. So he swipes second successfully, but you have to wonder now if that might actually end up taking the bat out of the hands of one of their better hitters.
Well, that's a good point, Matt, but I'd be a little surprised if that's the case. It's still early and the game is tied, so that would be a pretty cautious move to pitch around him here or just walk him flat out.
And it's fouled away.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. A swing and a ground ball to third. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Batting for the center fielder, Cody Bellinger.
Cody Bellinger at the plate now. First opportunity for him here with the leadoff man still standing at second. Two gone now. The set and the 1-1. And a knuckle curve missed that time. 2-1. Betts stands at second with two gone. Fouled away. In the dirt here. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
That can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball has gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it. He was there, and now he's only 90 feet away.
Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. Cody Bellinger puts a pair on the board with that homer. And the Dodgers move in front now 2-0.
What a way to start this one off. Scoreless top of the frame, and you answer with a bomb in the bottom of the first.
Stepping in now, Will Smith. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two out, nobody on. Weak grounder back to the mound. Throw on to Voit takes care of him, and the inning is over. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run home run. Second inning coming up. It's now 2-0 L.A. Giancarlo Stanton now. His lifetime numbers against Kershaw. He's got 5 base hits in 18 at-bats. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
Standing in now, Luke Voigt. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup. And he fouls this one off. Another 1-2 delivery. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
3-2, full count. Now the payoff pitch home. Fastball too low, and that's ball 4.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Now at the plate, here is Gleyber Torres. Outside, 2-1.
Boy, that's a nasty breaking ball right there. Backdoor slider, just missed the corner. As they say, that's a Hall of Fame pitch.
The 2-1. Fouled off. Runners on first with one down. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball 4.
Down the left field line and deep. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. And he misses again. Ball 4. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks in bunches, and that's already 2 walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
Now at the plate, Gio Urshela. Fastball is looked at for strike 2. Runners are at first and second with one away. Skied into very shallow right. Betts has a read on it. He's got it, and there are 2 down now. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with 2 away now.
Batting it.
2 men on, 2 out. And that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. The 2-2. Grounded weakly down the line toward third, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. From the belt, the pitch, Hit on the ground out to short, right to him. And the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. More ahead from Dodger Stadium right after this. Next up is Max Muncy.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood inning. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
To 2-2 now.
2-2.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2. And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitcher. For me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
So now to the plate, A.J. Pollock. Struck him out.
He's looking a lot sharper and has settled in here in the second inning. It'd be hard not to because that first inning was pretty much a mess. But I give him credit for letting it go and making some really good adjustments.
Into the box, Gavin Lux. And a fastball there is inside as that one backed him up a bit.
What makes hitting so difficult is covering both sides of the plate. And that hard pitch right there that was inside makes it awfully tough now to cover both the inside and the outside part of the plate.
Two balls and two strikes now. And it's fouled away. Fastball just inside. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out the side in order. So a pitching clinic there as he sets him down in order all via the punch out. We'll come right back with more from Dodger Stadium in just a moment. Now is Garrett Cole as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. The 1-1. There's a fastball that misses.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
He's got it. Hit the other way out toward right field. Betts has a read on it and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Now back.
And now DJ LeMahieu hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
And that was one of the hardest hit balls they've had all game, Maddie. It's been a pretty feeble effort by his teammates on the offensive side.
And that misses 2-1.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. We'll have to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
Fouled away. Yankees still on the lookout for hit number one here. And that misses there, so he runs to count full now. Now the 3-2 pitch. Line toward right center. That's a hit, the first of the game for the Yankees.
That's the difference in today's games. Pitchers will throw any pitch in any count, but the batter was able to deliver on a 3-2 breaking ball.
At the plate, Aaron Judge. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two. The 1-2. And he fouls this one off.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
He'll try again, 1-2.
That's a ball.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. In the dirt, did he go around? Yes, he did. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And that's going to move that runner into scoring position now.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. More ahead from Dodger Stadium right after this. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and up next will be the pitcher Clayton Kershaw. Dodgers pitcher trying to deal with a 1-2 count at the plate.
Well, that's a surprising late swing on a heater, middle cut right there. In a fastball count, he's going to have to turn it up a notch.
And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. And sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full, 3-2. And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Boy, he's really on a roll on the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
In now, Mookie Betts. And they set up away with the fastball, but it misses, 3-1.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Well, he walked him on five pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
Now a throw over. Runner back safely. Three and one is the count to the Dodgers shortstop. The 3-1. And he misses again here. It's ball four. And that's back-to-back walks here with one away.
Yeah, the pitching coach would hate to go to the bullpen this early in the game, but sometimes you have no choice. On the flip side, he might just get in his face a little bit out there, try to challenge him, wake him up from his funk. Either way, we'll see how it works.
Couple of runners on base with one down, and that'll bring up the third baseman, Justin Turner. The 2-1. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
Well, he's just lost complete control of the baseball in this inning. Two walks and now a wild pitch. You know he's talking to himself in his head. And I can't imagine he's saying any real nice things either.
And a swing and a miss and another punch out here. Six already. And that's out number two. Two on, two out, and here comes Cody Bellinger. That's the runner at third. Seager on his second with two down. And this is low, ball two. 2-1. And, ooh, that strike zone's getting a little inconsistent now. It's 2-2.
You know, this isn't a ballpark that yields a lot of runs, so when you've got a chance like this to put some early runs on the board, it becomes really important to do so.
Fouled off. Two and two. Here it is.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Too high, and that cost him ball four.
When a guy homers off you early in the game, the last thing you want to do is challenge him and maybe have him do it again. He was a lot more careful with him there.
So the bases are loaded here, two men gone, and that brings up Will Smith. The 1-1. A ball and two strikes now. Bases are loaded here, two down. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. A big time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. We'll come right back with more from Dodger Stadium in just a moment. Back with Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian, and leading off the inning, the big right-handed slugger Giancarlo Stanton. And it misses, 3-1 now. Into the windup and the pitch.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Now here's a fly ball. Well hit. Back goes Betts at the track. And just short of a home run, this ball's off the wall. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Now batting.
So up until this point, they've had to bite and scratch for every single thing. But he puts a good swing on this one and nearly knocks it out of the park. So we'll see if it's contagious and his partner can pick him up right here.
To the plate now, Luke Voit. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Here now the 2-2. No one out with a runner at second. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Into the box now, Gleyber Torres. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that pitch.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Now, after back-to-back strikeouts, he's got a real good chance of making that leadoff double pretty much meaningless. He's made some good pitches, and these hitters have really failed driving him in or at least getting him over.
Plate now, Gio Urshela hit hard to short, scooped up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. One left for the Yankees. They trail things here 2-0. Welcome back to Dodger Stadium. Let's send it down to the field in Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. He cited the 4 walks they've earned already as evidence that his guys are waiting for the right pitch and that they're willing to let the opposition work themselves into trouble. So far, that's paying off.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. He'll lead things off against Gerrit Cole. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ball game for him.
One of the toughest pitches to hit, the straight changeup, right? El Cambio. Hadn't seen it in that entire at bat. What happens? Gets the string pulled on him right there. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Stepping in now, A.J. Pollock. Ball 3. 3-2 now. Gavin Lux, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. Hit in the air to left. Stanton has a read on it. 2 gone.
The batter, number 9.
And stepping in, Gavin Lux struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7, 8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here. Hey, you think back to the early innings right there. You thought this guy would have been hitting his showers. A credit to him. He's been able to regroup, find his mechanics, and find a way to stay in this game.
And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Dodgers down in order, but they're on top 2-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher, Gary Sanchez. Now the 1-1 pitch. Lined hard toward right center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. Absolutely scorched that base hit. Worthy of some show track love, and as you see it, it came off the bat at 110 miles an hour. That's definitely squaring a ball up. Into the box, Gerrit Cole. And the pitcher is, in fact, bunting here as he puts this one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
Now back
to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up DJ LeMahieu. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Now the 2-1. Skied into straightaway right. On the move is Betts. He gets there, and that's the second out. So next to hit is Aaron Judge, runner in scoring position with two gone. Two out here and a runner at second. And it's a ball and two strikes now to Aaron Judge.
Offered at that breaking ball below the zone, and that's a tough one to spit on. But the key is recognizing it coming out of the pitcher's hand earlier and making sure that it goes up before it comes down. More likely to be a hanger when that's the case.
To two balls and two strikes now.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
From the stretch. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Yanks leave one. They're still down. It's 2. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and up next will be the pitcher, Clayton Kershaw. Now the 1-1 pitch.
You got two balls.
Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 2-1. Ball even at 2-2. Had the weight back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. And he struck him out. So double digits now, 10 strikeouts for him thus far.
That's 10 strikeouts for him now, and I'll tell you, he could rack up quite a few more before he's done. Still a lot of game left in this one.
Yes.
So now to the plate, Mookie Betts. And a slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort. And right into the shift. but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Loud contact by Mookie and a ball carrying well to left field. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run. A solo home run there for Mookie. And the Dodgers have now taken a 3-0 lead.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
At the plate, Corey Seager. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Three runs, just two hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Hicks is under it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now.
Now batting.
Next up is Justin Turner. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Here's the 1-2 delivery. This one's down to third. Reined in. Throw on to Voigt, takes care of him, and the inning is over. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. Now the 2-1 pitch. Will not catch the zone, ball three.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
Lifted down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Now the 3-2 pitch. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And he misses again, ball three. And through just five innings, he's coming up on 100 pitches now.
Yeah, Matty, I think one of the things you want to do is try to drive that pitch count up. And D-Row, if you're the offense right now, you're sitting in a pretty good spot.
Yeah, usually the starting pitcher doesn't get to see the lineup three times through. I wouldn't be shocked if there's a move made to the bullpen here.
Full count now, 3-2. Hicks gets his lead at first, nobody out. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ball game.
That's just a great pitch, both on the call from the catcher and the execution. If he hits it, there's a good chance it turns into a double play ball, but it's also a spot that's going to get a lot of whiffs too. That's excellent pitching.
Into the box now, Luke Voigt. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees' first baseman. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. No runs, three hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. One there. On to first. And he really paid the price at second base. But it's a double play. And the inning is over. Yanks held in check. They trail it here 3-0. Justin Wilson enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for the Yankees, number 34, Justin Wilson.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that brings up the former National League MVP, Cody Bellinger. The 3-1 pitch. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
Here now is Will Smith. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. And here's a slider for a called strike, and he's behind 1-2 now. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Nobody out, runner on first. 2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. Now a move over to first. Throw is up the line as it gets away. And this is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
In now, Max Muncy. And it's fouled away. One out and a runner on second base. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Now the 3-2 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. On the move is Stanton. But he can't get there, and it bounces over the wall. It's a ground rule double.
And this thing bounces over the wall, but I don't think it would have mattered if it stayed in the ballpark. Either way, the runner was going to score, and he was going to wind up at second. He drove that ball really nicely.
To the plate now, A.J. Pollock. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. From the belt, kicks and deals. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And no one will track it down. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. Now to the plate, Gavin Lux. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. He struck out in each of his first two plate appearances so far. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Now another 1-2. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Memories being made at the ballpark tonight, as they should be. More ahead from Dodger Stadium right after this. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres. Now the 2-1. Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Wow, talk about a waste pitch on 2-2. That one wasn't even close. I don't know anyone that would have swung at that pitch.
Scorched to third. And that's through into left. So a leadoff single here to start the seventh.
Now batting, the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
Standing in now, Gio Urshela. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. From the stretch. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2. And he rings up another one. Make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game.
The bottom third of the lineup hasn't put up a lot of resistance in this one. Pretty much has been sure outs other than that one hit. That really puts a lot of pressure on other guys to make stuff happen. These aren't the guys you usually count on, but it certainly helps if they can do something productive.
Into the box, Gary Sanchez. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
3-2 now. Fouled away.
I mean, this offense has struggled because they haven't been able to make the adjustment. He stayed staunch on the outer half, and these guys have not worked the ball the other way.
The next 3-2. Takes this the other way to right. That's in for a base hit, and he's 2-for-3. And that runner will hold up at second with 2 aboard now.
Hey, this might be their best opportunity to at least get on the board. They've been struggling offensively, and they find themselves with 2 runners on board. Let's see if they can continue it.
Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Corey Knebel will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the 8th spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Chris Taylor will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Mike Tauchman will get the call to pinch hit here, and he'll find he has a couple of runners aboard with only 1 out in the inning. The 1-1 home. On the ground, back up the box, and it'll get through into center field. A base hit. Long throw to the plate. And not in time as the run scores.
Now back. Second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Stepping in now, DJ LeMahieu. Could take there to lay off the high fastball. His head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel. He's hitless in 6 tries. Good time to call the change as he swings and misses for strike 2. Sanchez on 2nd. Tauchman is over at first with 1 away. Sent on the ground out to 2nd, and that's through into right field for a base hit. And a good throw is going to hold that runner at 3rd, so they're loaded now with only 1 away.
Boy, D-Row, when you're starting to swing it like this team, it doesn't matter. They bring in a new relief pitch, right? And he gets greeted with back-to-back base hits.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you want to do. In today's day and age of bullpen down your throat, You very rarely see back-to-back knocks when these guys are throwing smoke.
That's one of the keys, too. When you come in facing guys out of the bullpen, they're being taught to throw strikes early, and they're taking advantage of it. He's throwing strikes, and they're jumping all over him.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Count even at 2-2. Bases are loaded with only one out. And this is swung on and missed, a huge out there, as the bases will stay loaded with two away now.
That's a big strike out there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
Into the box now, Aaron Hicks. Oh, and this could be trouble now. It's 3-1.
You fight so hard to get into these type of counts, you can't let this pitch get away from you. You have to keyhole something middle of the plate.
He's set, the 3-1. Oh, and it misses, ball four, and that will force home a run.
Now that,
and it's times like these field that a pitcher feels awfully lonely. I can see why he didn't want to be too aggressive. Last thing he wants to do is give up a grand slam to a dangerous hitter, but walking in a run is painful too, and here he is again still with the bases loaded.
Your Joe Kelly, please, answers the call to pitch now, here in a big spot. He inherits a bases loaded jam, but needs just one out to get out of it.
Kelly.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. Lifetime versus Joe Kelly. He's gone 2-for-8. And there's ball two now. Ready with the 2-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Big spot. Two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
Wow, they went to the pen because they liked the matchup. And what does he do? He walks the first guy he faces to bring in a run. So much for that strategy. Makes you wonder if they'll turn to him again next time in this situation.
Next to hit, Luke Voit. A potential tying run for him at third base. The 1-1. Big spot. Two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Hit out towards second. And that is into center field as he comes through. It's a base hit. And the runner from second is in to score. It's a 5-4 game.
You know, it's awfully difficult to score runs late in the game. After being down by one, D-Ro, that base hit drives in two. That's a huge base hit.
What a momentum swing. What an AB right there. Now you got to grab your leather and go out and flash some D for the boys.
At the plate now, Gleyber Torres. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Two men are on with two men out. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. All in all, 10 men come to the plate and 5 score. Bottom of the 7th inning upcoming in L.A. Get up and stretch. The Yankees lead it 5-4. Darren O'Day gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home 7th.
The New York Yankees, number 56, Darren O'Day.
into the box. Chris Taylor, he's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number 7. The 1-2.
Ball in.
Went to the slider to try and get him to chase, but it's full now, 3-2.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order's coming up right behind him.
Popped him up. Sanchez is underneath this one. One gone. Stepping in is Mookie Betts. He went deep last time up.
Yeah, Matt, going back to that last at-bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
The 3-1. Swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
That's 3 straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well a 4th time. I'd be looking heated.
That's off the end of the bat foul, and he might have been fortunate to stay alive that time. A payoff pitch one more time. Yanked hard down the left field line. And now this will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
When you play in this park where the fences are shorter, this is going to happen more often than any other ballparks.
To the plate now, Corey Seager. He pulls this one into right, and that's in there. Base hit. The throw to the plate. He's safe at the plate, and this ball game is tied here in the 7th.
You know, D-Row, in today's game, it's not easy scoring in the late innings, so that RBI base hit to tie things up, that comes at a really good time.
Yeah, I say it's not easy. They got 11 guys in the bullpen, and I don't think a guy throws under 97 miles an hour with sinking cut. That is unbelievable he's able to get that knock in that big spot.
Standing in now, Justin Turner, lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that finds a seam for extra bases, as we'll see if they want to wheel that go-ahead run home from first. Now it's cut off, a throw to the plate. Oh, and the tag will get him at home plate as that keeps the ball game tied.
With 2 outs, I totally understand sending him there, but with only 1 out, you've got to be pretty positive about getting him home safely. Could have been a whole lot better than what they're working with now.
In now, Cody Bellinger. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Ready with the 1-2. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with 2 down. And he fouls this one off. One and two, here it is. And strike 3 called, as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. We'll come right back with more from Dodger Stadium in just a moment. Victor Gonzalez has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th.
Number 81, Victor Gonzalez.
All set for the start of the inning, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Gio Urshela. Sinker is right there for a called strike 2.
1-2.
Yeah. Still a ball and two strikes. Here he comes again. 1-2. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Here's another 2-2. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Pollock has a read on it. One down.
Up next for the Yankees.
Stepping up is Gary Sanchez. He's 2 for 3 and looking for more here. The 2-1 home. Taken, strike two.
Don't expect too many more high fastballs in this one. He is known for his sinker, keeping the ball on the ground.
A full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes. One out, nobody on. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Hit sharply on the ground, and that's through for a hit. If you're wondering what's left on the Yankees bench, there you go. We'll see if they think about making a move here. Clint Frazier will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 77, Clint Frazier.
Oh, looked like he was towing an anchor there. 1-2.
He's gone to the well with that pitch 3 times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Possible go-ahead runs on first. One away. Oh, on the ground is short. Could this be two? There's one. Throw to Muncy to finish the double play. That retires the side. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. And we are all tied 5-5. Jonathan Loaisiga is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 43, Jonathan Loaisiga.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and now it'll be the catcher, Will Smith. The 1-1 takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Shin high, that's taken for a ball. And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Man, when the game is tied, the last thing you can afford to do is walk the leadoff hitter. Got to focus on getting that ground ball now.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. And that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. The 3-1 pitch. This is going to get down for extra bases. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning. That base hit was screaming off the bat. And our show track technology more than confirms it. 111 miles an hour was the exit velocity of that line drive. Next up for Los Angeles,
A.J. Pollock.
It's been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force play is now in order.
Well, they felt it was better to take the bat out of the hands of a guy like that. He's just too dangerous, and they decided they'll take their chances with the next guy in the lineup. Thank you.
Smith at third, Muncy at second, Pollock on at first with nobody out. Swing and a softly hit ground ball. Needs a punch out here. Can he get it? Hit hard on the ground to short. A diving effort as it's off his glove. And there is some stick-to-itiveness as they still manage to get the out at first. What a play. Outstanding range on display that time. And here's the data from ShowTrack. I didn't think he was going to get to that one, but he did. And then to complete the play, he made a fantastic throw right on the money. That batter's got to feel like he got robbed on that ball. Into the box, Chris Taylor. Gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2. And it looks like the Yankees will have a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. High in the air down the right field line. Heading after it is Judge. He makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. And the run is in to score from third. Now a 7-5 game.
Now that every team is looking for that insurance run late in the game. That run right there gives them a 2-run lead heading into the late innings.
Here's Mookie Betts. And it looks like this could be a critical at-bat in this one.
Well, a glance at my scorebook shows they haven't been able to get him out yet. So this could be a fun at-bat to watch.
Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. Men on third with two down. In there, and it's even now. 2-2.
Hey, there aren't too many power hitters in the game that would let that pitch go by.
Softly hit out to short. And he will deliver one of the biggest at-bats of the night. It's a base hit. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead. It's now an 8-5 game. So three runs on only two hits in the inning. No errors and no one left on base. We've played eight full. Dodgers out in front, 8-5. Kenley Jansen takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Number 73, Kenley.
Into the box now, DJ LeMahieu lifted in the air toward the line and right. On the move is Betts, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. Here's Big Aaron Judge. shot sent off to the right side, but foul. Three-two pitch. And that's outside. He lost him, ball four.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that with too much.
So now to the plate, Aaron Hicks, who jumped the gun a bit on that swing, and he's down 1-2.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Two balls and two strikes to Hicks now. Still 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Now the 1-1 pitch. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there. Next up, Luke Voit. He singled and drove home two his last time.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
Last chance for the Yankees. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Well, folks, that's what Kenley Jansen does. When he enters the game, the hopes of the other team, they usually just leave. Slams the door again right here.
8-5 tonight. Los Angeles crossed the plate three times in the eighth, helping propel them to the win. Victor Gonzalez earns the victory on the mound. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers, 8 runs on 8 hits. No errors. They left 6 men on base.